Melbourne is on the brink of a population boom as thousands return to the city after fleeing interstate during COVID lockdowns. Removalists are experiencing a surge in bookings from families and singles relocating from Queensland to Victoria. Some are return customers who only left the state 2 years ago. Jade Kotick has this exclusive.
Moving season is underway. And there's been a major shift towards Melbourne from ghost town to boom town.
We can see where Australians are moving to in the future. And at the moment, all signs are pointing to Melbourne.
There was a mass exodus from Victoria during 2020 and 2021, with almost 32,000 people relocating interstate to avoid lockdown. But not everyone has decided to stay.
So we've had about 20% of those customers move back down to Melbourne. We've also seen an influx in Brisbane clients making the decision to move down to Melbourne as well.
New data from Moveall reveals Melbourne accounts for 27% of all inbound moving inquiries.
I do feel like a bit of a cheat coming back and, you know, escaping it all.
Nathan Moyer left for Adelaide in October 2020 during our second lockdown. 2 years later...
The opportunities for the career that I'm in were just far greater in Victoria than they are in South Australia.
The bulk of new residents are from Adelaide and Sydney.
The idea of being closer to family is appealing to a lot of people. I probably wouldn't have moved to be closer to family pre-COVID.
Cost of living is also a major factor behind the mass migration. Amanda Hampson recently moved to Fitzroy from Sydney's Northern Beaches, where the author lived for 23 years.
For what I can get here, the quality, the standard, the proximity to the city, there is no way I could afford to have something like this in Sydney.
That it's a mix of everybody. People who had moved out of Melbourne during COVID, during that mass exodus, are coming back, but also people are coming for just a change of lifestyle.
Data from the ABS is yet to play catch up. In the 12 months to March, Victoria's interstate migration was still at a net loss. The population boom largely driven by international arrivals.
It is actually net overseas migration that is really driving the majority of the growth that Melbourne is experiencing at the moment.
Demographers from McCrindle say Melbourne is still on track to surpass Sydney as the most populated city by 2030, again largely driven by overseas migration.
We think Melbourne has an incredible future ahead of it as a thriving, vibrant Australian and global city.
Jade Kotick for 10 News First.